From his great American tower to the 200-plus ice cream counters that were the source of his vast fortune, the Tri-State tonight is mourning and remembering so many acts of kindness over 92 years by our billionaire benefactor, Carl Lindner Jr. Many of his achievements are as prominent as that tower.
Others are much more subtle, like the one down at the Freedom Center. News 5's John London has that part of our team coverage tonight. John?
Well, Cherie, you know, when most people think of Carl Lindner, they think of high finance and big business, but he busied himself with a lot of other important matters that are hidden well beneath the surface of the skyline that he helped shape. Carl Lindner was known community-wide for his grand-scale projects like the Great American Tower and Great American Ballpark and his prior ownership of the Reds. But inside the Freedom Center, there is a display in the Heroes section on the third floor that honors a Lindner success story that is not as well known.
For 200 years, the white Masons didn't recognize the black Masons or vice versa. And I thought that was not right.
Neither did Steve Reese, who, like Lindner, is a 33-degree Mason. They collaborate to end the parallel yet separate Masonic societies. In December of 94, Reese and Lindner gathered Masons from all over the country to the Cincinnatian Hotel.
It was quite a risk, and Carl got right with me and said, Steve, you know, what do we need to do? How do we do it? Let's make the calls. If I asked him to make a call, I said I couldn't reach. He made the call.
To this day, because of their joint efforts, the Masons conduct integrated programs and fellowship and brotherhood activities, in keeping with Lindner's lifelong philosophy of fairness and giving back.
My family helped start a YMCA in the West End, and we just thought it was good. We're a blessed family, and we just thought it was right and good to share.
Carl Lindner had a soft-spoken way of expressing himself, as you heard there, but his words carried weight. Steve Reese says tonight he will miss him as a friend, and he also told us he thinks that's the way this community will feel the loss as well. Reporting live downtown, John London, News 5. John.